Here we go. Okay, let's start. So maybe you have some blocks around or something that makes you feel comfortable with adding into your practice for any arm balances or things like that, or triangle pose. We're gonna do a little bit of hip opening today with some pigeons. We'll do one leg pigeon too. Okay, we'll skip that other one that we've been practicing, the one where we wrap ourselves up like a pretzel. All right, let's start with our flowing mountain, breathing in, reaching up. Breathing out, bringing the hands back towards the earth. Start to notice the air on your skin. The air that enters your body. Going as fast as you want to, matching your movement to your breath. Pressing down into both of our feet. Let's turn this right into a flowing chair. Breathe in, reach up. Breathe out, sitting back into our chair. Breathe in, sweep up. Breathe out, come down. Creating some big circles with our arms, warming up our shoulders. Wonderful. Really going to warm up those shoulders today. We'll come back to our mountain pose and step our left foot back the length of our mat. So flying bird, heel is high, breathe in, breathe out, step to chair. Breathe in, back, breathe out, forward. And if you want to, a small back bend, you look up and exhale forward. So to take it more, well, take a little bit off, you would step to mountain instead of chair. If you want to make it harder, you never really bend that, straighten that front leg. All right, let's hold it back. Take the left heel down onto the mat, or whichever one you have back, and start to move through some moonflowers. Breathe in, reach up. Breathe out, sit back. Close your eyes as much as you can today. Sitting back towards that back edge of our mat, drawing our elbows towards our back pockets, and being kind to our knees. This will now turn into our sunflower when we hinge down towards the mat. Sorry, Debbie, just realized I didn't have my microphone on. All right, turning that into our sunflowers. Chop. We'll hold it down in our goddess pose. So we're down, elbows up. Staying there for a breath or two. We'll shift the weight over on to one foot. So let's shift, lift that toe. Shift, lift the other toe. It's like you're sliding your backside along. You bench back behind, just try to slide across. Like this. You can stay with that one or hold over on one side, bringing the left elbow down onto whichever knee you have. So same side, same elbow, and reaching the other arm up. And shifting to the other side, you can have your heel up, or sorry, your toes up or down, or a side angle. Good job. Then we'll turn to face the front of our mat again, our front toes step to forward fold, and start to fold through our halfway lifts, halfway up, and then fold. All on your own, drawing the shoulders away from the ears, pressing into both feet. Both big toes connect, both pinky toes connect. Not all of the weight of the heels, we're trying to disperse that weight. Last one, hop, step, or jump, back to plank pose, a full plank or kneeling plank. We're not there for too long, about three breaths until we come to all fours. Soften the jaw. We'll make our way to all fours, knees right underneath our hips. We'll slide those hands underneath the shoulders and some circles with our hips, going one side, some figure eights actually. One out to the side, back, and then slide it back to neutral, and then the other side. Just check in with our knees. There's some space between them. So so that our knees are under our hips. Oh, that feels lovely. And right into our cat and cow, exhaling into cat, inhaling into cow. Fists for wrists are a great option. One vertebrae at a time. So take your time to really focus on your spine. Starting at one end, moving through with that final of the lifting of the head. Then you start back at the base, roll through until the head goes down. Last one. Child's pose or downward facing dog. Do what feels best for your body today, pressing the earth away. Or being more restful in child's pose. My oxygen to people that wonderful. Let's add that half series. We come forward into a full or kneeling plank. Halfway or all the way down, moving into up dog or cobra. If you're in cobra, back to your belly and then down dog. Or straight back to down dog. Let's do that three more times on your own. Modifying or resting. Wherever you are, take your time. We'll meet in down dog or child's pose on your last round through. Once we get into our downward dog, we'll do tail of the dog and wag our tail. So lifting the right foot up, bending the right knee, and wagging your heel. Wagging our tail, warming up our hip. And then letting that heel go towards the opposite side of the mat. Looking under our armpit, to three-legged dog. Switching feet, starting with your wag the dog first. Wag our tail. And if it feels okay, that opening up, dropping that heel back. Still pressing into both of our feet. And the hand foot that's up will now sweep up between the hands. Take your time, whatever foot it is, most likely your left. Rise up into our lunge pose. Exhale, bringing the right hand down to the mat, left hand up for a twist. We'll be making our way to chair before we do the lunge on the other side. So untwist first, step to chair. Step the opposite foot back. Left hand down, right hand up for your twist or whichever one. The opposite hand to your foot that's down. Twist towards the knee. When you're ready, we'll all make our way to forward fold. No rush. Let the head hang. No stress on the neck. Halfway up. Hold, breathe out. Chair pose, breathe in. All the way up into our mountain pose. All right, roll those wrists around a little bit, adjust our clothes, grab a drink, and we'll head into those sun salutations. All right, switch this to. I do have a playlist that's all sun salutations. Maybe I'll put one of those songs on there a bit faster and I can crank it up. Just takes me a second to get to them because I share this music with my kids. So there's lots of playlists on here. All right, this was a new one. My daughter sent me this one. All right, up to the tops of our mats. Let's close our eyes, widen across our chests. Relax our shoulders down. Soften the knees, engage the core. Breathe in, we'll sweep up. Exhale, fold. Halfway up, we'll breathe in. Fold, breathe out. One more fold, actually. And then that half, that jump back, chaturanga or plank, hold or flow into your up dog or your cobra. Feet back and down dog, no rush. Right foot between the hands, one lunge, one breath in. One breath out, back to chaturanga or plank. Hold or flow. Left foot between the hands, one lunge. Back to chaturanga or plank. Hold or flow, great job. Hold that plank. Knee to down dog, hop, step or jump between the hands. Halfway lift, breathe in. Fold, breathe out. Chair pose, breathe in. Back up to mountain. And again, sweep the sky. Dive to the earth. Halfway up. Hop, step or jump back. Hold your plank or flow through chaturanga and up dog. Down dog. Left foot up between the hands. Find your lunge, breathe in. Breathe out, downward dog. Or sorry, plank, chaturanga. Hold or flow. Downward dog. Right foot between the hands. Take your time, rise to your lunge. Breathe out, downward facing dog. Yeah, you guys are right. You were right, Elise, I was wrong. Hop, step, or jump up between the feet. I've got like halfway up. Fold, chair, all the way up. You've got two. Pardon? I know, you don't even need me anymore. All the way up. Dive and pull. This one will get it right. Halfway lift. Hop, step, or jump back to plank or chaturanga. Downward dog. Right foot between the hands. One lunge. Chaturanga or plank. Flow or hold. Downward dog. Left foot lunge. Chaturanga or plank. Up dog or hold. Downward dog. Hop, step, or jump. Take your time. Halfway lift. Fold. Chair, breathe in. Up into our mountain. One more. One more. Let's get this heat. We're going to add a twist onto that lunge. Rise up. Exhale, dive. Halfway lift. Hop, step, or jump. Hold or flow. Meet in downward dog. A little change here, right foot between the hands, left hand stays down, twisted lunge, breathe in, reach the right hand up. Back to plank or chaturanga. Hold or flow, downward dog. Left foot lunges, right hand stays down, reach the left hand up, lunge. Back to plank or chaturanga. Hold or flow, downward dog, we're almost there. Hop, step, or jump. Up we go. Halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Chair, breathe in. All the way up. All right, relax those shoulders. Good job. We just wanted to kind of go with our music, so I think it's about 10.
Yeah, we'll do a few faster flow songs today.
All right, let's get on with our practice. Moving into some warriors. Right foot forward, left foot back. Heel goes down right into warrior two, softening through our shoulders. So our right foot pointing towards the top of our mat. And we're anchoring through both of our feet. Breathe. We'll be flowing to warm up our obliques between side angles. So that left hand or left elbow to the elbow or down to the floor. And then right up to reverse warrior, come back up. Right hand lifts up. We'll flow between those two. So in one pose, we've got our left hand reaching towards the window. And in the other one, reaching up for the sky. Think of the sides of your body lifting you and lowering you right now. The muscles. Last one, holding in your side angle, right hand down, left hand up or long. Amazing. We'll be lifting our back heel
and bringing our hands to the mat. So into a runner's lunge. Bring the back knee down. We can pick it back up after. Walk this foot out. And if you want to, do a little stretch up to one side or come down to your forearms. If you want to, lift the back kneecap up. We'll drop that knee down. Bring the foot back in, sole of the foot on the mat. Draw our hand back. Just creating some muscle memory, that elbow going underneath. And then that modification, if you want to walk your foot out until your foot lifts. Oh, and lift your back leg if you want to. Great job. Bring it back in, foot in, hand in. Tuck those toes, downward facing dog. You can hold here in down dog or child's pose, or take a little flow through your half series or hold. We'll do the same sequence on the other side. Left foot up between the hands. Back heel down, warrior two, so our right hand's back, left hand is forward. And then we add our flow to activate our obliques, down to side angle, reach long, all the way up to reverse warrior. You can close your eyes and anchor to your breath. Keeping our chest open towards that long edge of our mat. Holding it side angle. Breathe. Feel the length and the openness across the top part of your body, the strength of your core. We'll lift our back heel, bring our hands inside that front foot, drop the back knee. Great. So first we'll do our little walk the foot out, let it go onto the outside of that foot or come down to forearms. Awakening our hips today and many other parts of our bodies also. Bring the sole of the foot back down onto earth, bring it in a little bit. That knee that now is more in towards your shoulder, hugging your shoulder. And then you make your shelf with your hand coming out. And if you want to, we walk our toes forward. So we're trying, yeah, great work. If you want to work towards lifting your back knee up, you can. Progress, not perfection. Make our way to child's pose. Hips are awakened. Take a little rock side to side in your child's pose. This is a nice massage for your internal organs. Inhale, all fours. Exhale, downward facing dog. Breathe. We'll flip our dog over today. We already did that halfway earlier. We lift our right foot up into three-legged dog. Bend our right knee and start to let that hip open up so the left foot is going out to the back end of your mat. And then we drop it down on the mat, lift up with hand either up or reaching towards me more wildly. Take your time, we'll make our way back to downward facing dog. Can rest there or flow through one vinyasa, your plank, up dog, and then meet back in down dog, or rest, give your wrists some love like I'm doing. Three-legged dog or flip dog on the other side, left foot lifts, inhale, exhale, open. Inhale if you want to flip and then lift that chest, we'll hold here for three breaths. Feel the strength of your legs, your core. Smile. You're alive. Your body is here. Downward dog. Flip back.
Hop, step, or jump up between those feet. Halfway lift. Fold. Chair, breathe in.
Exhale, rise up. Okay, pigeon pose. Wouldn't be a good hip opener class without our pigeon pose. So if we want to do one leg pigeon pose, that's where we'll head with our bolsters if you decide to use your bolster today. Or blocks. Okay. Do you want to bolster, Sonia? Oh, just stay up and open your hips, actually. Yeah. So if you're doing hips, then you want to stay up. If you want to practice your arm balance, then you go down. So right foot comes across. We've got a flexed right foot. And then we bend our left knee. This is pigeon. Keeping the chest up if we're going to stay up and enjoy this. If you would like to add our arm balance on, we must bend the left knee more. Wrap our right foot, so your right foot, around the back of your arms is where you want to create that shelf eventually. And the other hand would be creating a shelf for right in front of your knee. So we walk forward, create your shelf. Maybe look forward, lift your toe. And remember, progress, not perfection. Take your time, we'll come on up. And then try the other side. Flex the left foot, sit it back, enjoy pigeon pose for about the next 10 to 15 breaths, or come down and practice working towards our one leg pigeon. We want to make sure we're looking forward at our bolster, walking our hands, looking forward, lifting the foot. Whew. Make sure you're breathing. I'm not sure I was breathing in that one. Come all the way up. Great job. We're going to do pigeon down on the mat now. Take a breath in, sweep up. Exhale, dive. Step back to downward dog just for that exhale. And then the right knee coming to the outside of your right hand or right behind the right wrist. Our left knee kneecap down on the mat. And sinking down into pigeon pose. This is where you could stack your fists to rest your forehead. Or bring your chest closer to the floor. We have a bolster, it feels really good lengthwise. Snug it right in. Lay down. Restorative pigeon. All right, we can put our slower music on now, Denise. Meditations too. All right, my friends. A few more breaths. You can stay in restorative pigeon, or we'll make our way up into king pigeon. Press our hands into the mat, engage the core, lifting up. We can bend and straighten our back leg, just kind of activate our hamstring. Now, if that doesn't feel good for your knee, then go back to your regular pigeon pose. If you want to try king pigeon, kind of start by reaching back with the same side, see how that feels, then the opposite side, pick one. Personally, I like to do the opposite. I feel like that's more accessible just for my body. And then if it feels nice, we engage the core, lift the top hand up. Ooh. Hello, hips and quads. Let's do the other side. Sweep that left knee around to the front. Bring that right foot back all the way until the kneecap comes down onto the mat. And then settle into our pigeon on this side, stretching our hips. A good pose for back pain as well. About 10, 15 breaths here. It is okay to relax. It is okay to let go of thoughts just for a few moments. Give your mind a little break.
You can stay here or move up into our king pigeon. We come up.
Start with the bending and the straightening of our leg. If it feels good for you, reaching back and then reaching the opposite arm up. Find the breath and we'll all make our way to child's pose. Take your time. Let's do a nice wide leg child's pose if that feels good for you. Big toes towards each other. We can rest our belly between our inner thighs. And it's nice and restful. Moving into puppy pose for our upper back and our posture, especially if you've been sitting at a desk all day. The knees come under the hips and the hips come up over top of the knees. So now those hips aren't back towards our heels. They're right on top of our knees. We walk our hands forward and bring our chest towards the mat with our hips high. So there's a few modifications for this. You could put blocks under your elbows, bring your hands back behind your head. Drawing that space between the shoulder blades slightly together and opening our chest up towards the mat, so letting that chest go towards the earth.
Amazing job, everybody. Make your way just to your bellies.
We'll move into Sphinx pose. Elbows come underneath our shoulders. We'll push our heads like a little turtle peeking out of the shell. We'll come on up. Lengthen that space between our ears and our shoulders like you have some nice dangling earrings on, maybe some beaded ones. Drawing the shoulder blades down towards the spine so our backside is relaxed here at the moment. Shake it out a little bit if you want to. Relax it down. We'll be pushing up back to onto our back. So take your time, whatever position you want to be in, wherever you want your head to be at the foot edge of your mat. We'll draw our knees into our chest. Take a lovely rock side to side. We'll just be adding in one little twist before our Shavasana. Our regular tip twist. So we've got our arms out like wings, extending one leg, bending the opposite knee, and drawing it across the body. Now, if there's another pose that speaks to you right now you'd like to do, of course, do whatever feels good. Give your body permission to unwind, to bring out. All the way over to the other side, extending one leg, drawing the knee across. Nice gentle twists are good. Very beneficial, especially if we do them at the end of practice, holding these longer twists. Once our spine has been warmed up, draw those knees into chest. We'll roll back onto our back. Take one more rock side to side before we settle into Shavasana. It's 12:43, so we've got a couple minutes. Add in another pose if you want to, or settle right in. Close your eyes. Make yourself comfortable. Soften the areas of our body that may need to be softened. I'm going to read just a little bit about peace today. One of my lovely books. This book is yoga themes for modern yogis. Peace. Peace is a state of equality and tranquility that is experienced among beings or within the self. It is a harmonious existence, and it requires being at ease and accepting of others and ourselves. These feelings of peace can be practiced in yoga by coming to terms with ourselves, respecting others, and finding a state of calm. Overall, yoga is a peaceful practice. It encourages us to be at peace with ourselves, experience a more peaceful mindset, and experience harmony with all beings through unconditional respect. To set peace as an intention, just allow this desire for harmony to shape your intentions today. Quote about peace, there's two actually, one by Mahatma Gandhi: when the power of love overcomes the love of power, the world will know peace. And Albert Einstein said, peace cannot be kept by force, it can only be achieved by understanding. Our fingers and our toes. Take your time making your way out of your shavasana. We're moving our head side to side, and then in your own time making your way up into an easy seated position. Softening our shoulders, ready for the rest of our day. Taking a big breath in. Let's fill it up with peace for yourselves, accepting of yourself, and exhale. Feeling out into the world. One more big, beautiful breath in. Cleansing and exhaling, letting go. Feels nice. We can bow towards Mother Earth. Namaste. Thank you. Enjoy the rest of your day. It's 12:47. I went 2 minutes over. Sorry.
Bye, Debbie. Have a wonderful day. Let me know about next week if you want to do the Pilates or if I'm missing any things for you. Let me know.